Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, anytime you're watching this. I am Disha Shetty here to demonstrate a lab program for you. So we are learning computer graphics in our engineering if you are a computer science or an information science student. It's a major subject. So here I am to demonstrate you a program named as Perspective Viewing of a Cube in 3 Dimension, which is a lab program. So let us begin by knowing what are we going to exactly do in the program. So we are going to draw a color cube and allow the user to move the camera suitably and experiment with perspective viewing of a cube in OpenGL. So OpenGL is open graphics library that is available for you for your graphics programs. So what are we going to do basically in our program is we're going to draw a color cube. As you all know, a cube has 8 corners and 12 edges. Yes. So we are gonna draw that color cube. We're giving different colors to the different vertices. So it's gonna be a blend of colors using GL polygons. And then we're gonna allow the user to move the camera. That is, we're gonna let the user have interfaces using keyboard or mouse with the program so that whenever he presses the desired keys, the cube rotates accordingly and it shows the different views. We're also gonna implement a frustum in our program so we can see a part of the cube, a triangularly cut part of the cube. So yes, that's our program. So let us start by seeing the algorithm of our program. As you all know, a program should have a set of steps which it follows in order for the program to work. So in our program we have 8 major steps. So in the beginning we start, as always, and then we render the cube using array of vertices. Rendering is basically giving a real life image for it. So first we're going to render the cube using our reshape func, and then we obtain the coordinates of the cube with the origin at the center of the cube. So basically we are going to define a matrix, that is vertice matrix, where we're going to give the different points of our cube corners in form of x, y and z, where we assume that the origin is the center of the cube is in the origin. And then we're going to draw the 6 faces of the cube using 3 points. That is, we're going to mention our cube points, that is the corners, and we're going to draw it using polygon, GL polygon, and we're going to use normal vectors as well as colors matrix to draw a cube and increment the angle with respect to current axis by user specified value. That is, every time you press a key or you press a mouse button, we are going to change the value of our angle. That is, you need to rotate your cube in a particular direction, maybe x, y or z. So respectively we are going to change our angle, and you come to know what we are going to do as I explain you the code. So next step, that is the 6th step, is displaying the cube on the screen and rotating by the current value of the angle around the current matrix. This we do by using our display function. So first we're going to show our simple cube, and every time you use a keyboard or a mouse function to change the value of the cube, you display it again. So this also you will come to know as our program proceeds. And 7th one is you keep repeating steps 4 and 5. As I said, you can change n number of values in your keyboard and n number of mouses. That is basically what the program is. You get a perspective view of a cube. You can view the cube whole of 360 degree. And then we stop the program. So that is it with our algorithm. So now let us proceed with our program. So here we are with code blocks version 16.01 that I'm running on my Windows 10 with VMware Workstation Pro. So first we've initialized our header files, that is stdio and gl, where stdio is for C programs and gl is our graphics library. So next we initialize the 3 major matrix that we need in our whole program, that is vertices, colors and normals. So this all 3 are 8x3 matrices, where basically in normals and vertices, 8 stands for corners and 3 stands for xyz, whereas in colors, 8 stands for corners, whereas 3 stands for RGB. So now we start by writing our main function, and in our main function the major idea which is different from others is one is glut double, which we use in our display mode, which is for the two buffers that we need for our program since it's a 3D program. Same goes with glut depth, because it's a 3D program we need a depth buffer too. So we have four major functions in our program, and that is my reshape, that is reshape func, display func, mouse func, and keyboard func. So as the program proceeds, I'll explain you why each function is used. Also, the main line of a program is a GL enable GL depth test. So this is used for depth comparisons and updating the depth buffer. So as you know, our program is incomplete without this line. If you forget this line, no program. The program won't get executed at all. You'll get a blank, blank window which shows color cue. That's it. So not to scare you, but let us proceed with our program. I'm going to tell you what is our first function. Let's go to our first function, and that is reshape. So what does reshape do? Basically, reshape gives you the view of the cube every time you change its transformation. That is, if you rotate it right, it again draws the view for you. So first we see the viewport, and what viewport does is it basically does the affine transformations, okay? And the matrix mode helps in identifying which matrix is the current matrix. As you see here, it looks like the projection is the current matrix, whereas here the model view is the current matrix. Because here what we do is we project it. That is, every time you change or you do something in the projection, that is stored in this matrix. Whereas once the projection is done, it will be shown to you. So that is basically reshape matrix, and in which you use the load identity. So what does GL load identity does? It replaces a current matrix with an identity matrix. So and then we have frustum, and why is frustum used? I'll explain it to you when we have the output, because now you may not understand if I tell it to you. So that is our reshape function, and next we have our display function. So what does display function do? It basically displays whatever you do in the program. So first in our display function, what we do is clear. So we clear two buffer bits in our program, and that's color buffer bit and depth buffer bit. So this is basically done so that if any previous values are stored there, if any functions have been done which have not been cleared, we clear it. And there's a load identity again. So GL clear color is basically the background. If you want the background to be black, you just have to write 000, that's it. Whereas 111 gives you a white background. So next, what do you do in your lookat matrix? So lookat defines a viewing transformation, and that is that has 9 parameters for it. The first 3 is the viewer, that is how the viewer looks at it, that is viewer 0, viewer 1, or viewer 2. So by this, what I want to tell you is our 3, we define our 2 matrices and one of the values, that is theta, axis, and viewer. So basically viewer is given 0, 0, and 5.0. 5.0 is the z value of the z axis. So basically we are distance 5 units from the cube. You can make out what I'm trying to tell you when we have our output. So basically here we give viewer 0, viewer 1, and viewer 2 as the value of our program for the viewer matrix. And second part is the act, that is the target, where you want the cube to be. So basically we want a cube to be in the origin. And next is, what is the up vector? So our up vector is 0.1 and 0. So what we do after this is the 3 rotations via theta 0, theta 1, theta 2, that is our x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. So what we do next is we call a function called as color cube, and then we do swap buffers. So basically swap buffers is used in a 3D program, whereas in a 2D program we use GL flush. It does the same work, but here we do swap buffers as it's a 3D program and there's depth involved in it. So next let us go to our color cube. So color cube is basically a simple function that calls another function called as polygon and gives us values. So these four are the values of a corner of a cube. So what we do is we take cube with corners as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we start tracing every side of the cube. That is 0, 3, 2, 1 gives you the first face. 1, 2, 3, 6, 5 gives you another face, another face, another face. So there are 6 faces of a cube. And that is what we are doing. We are drawing the 6 faces of a cube using this function. So what do we do in polygon? So polygon function is here, which has 4 parameters as we've already given here. And what it does is it begins a polygon. It begins drawing a polygon. And we give 3 values each. That is colors, normals, vertex that we've defined here. So why color? We give one color to it and then we give a normal vector as well as the vertex. So now we have drawn this vertex with a set of colors. Then we drew the B vertex with a set of colors. And then we drew the C vertex with a set of colors. So finally, basically in the program, in the end of this, we'll have a cube ready. That is, which has 6 faces drawn by different polygons. So basically, we have 6 polygons in our program. It's not drawn as one whole cube because inside it's a hollow. Our cube is hollow inside. It's only seen by outside. So this many functions that we've written is only and only for our cube and what will happen if you change its projections. So now, how do we change the projections? This is done by our next two functions. So one, as I've already defined it here, it is our keys and mouse function. So in mouse, we have a button, we have a state, we have X and we have Y. So button is which button do you click? So if you have an external mouse, then you can actually see what's happening here. But in my mouse right now with the laptop, I have only 2 buttons, that is left and right. Here we also have a middle button. So what happens is when it's a left button, axis is 0. That is, X axis is taken. When it's right button, Y axis. And when it's, right button, it's Z axis. And middle button is Y axis. So as you can see, these 3 lines that we've written, these 3 lines are for the rotation as per as how we want it. That is, plus or 0 equal to 2 is the speed in which it rotates. And here it rotates with every change in our value. I forgot to mention a minus here. So this is how our cube is going to rotate based on this. As you remember, we had initialized a theta value right here. So according to this value itself, we're going to get our value over here. So next we have a keys function. That's the last function where we have used a keyboard as an interface, whereas here we use mouse as an interface. So keyboard interface for a different projection. And for this, we need 3 parameters, unsigned character key, that is any key that you press, X and Y, that is the vertex. So key equal to small x, that is if you type X, then your X, cube will rotate around X axis in an anti-clockwise direction. Same here clockwise, and if you Y, it will rotate in Y axis, here is Z axis. So why do we call display function every time after we finish our particular projection? Because we need to see what has happened actually in our cube. So that's why we call display function every time we finish a projection. So now I would like to show you the output of our program. And the output goes like this. See, this is our cube. Our cube is so beautiful. So this is our cube. And I am pressing the left mouse button right now. So it's rotating around Z axis, I think, X axis. Okay, so see how colorful our cube is, and this is happening just because of a color matrix. So next I'm going to rotate it around, I'm going to press the right mouse button and see how it rotates. Okay, so here what you see, this is because of frustum. If instead of frustum, if you've written ortho, then this wouldn't be visible. It would be visible as a corner itself. So here you can see a part of the cube, that is cut part of the cube, which looks like a triangle. So this is possible because of frustum. And this is our cube right now. Okay, let me make it straight. Okay. Yes. Okay, we have a straight, I think we have a straight cube. Okay, so next we have, I'm gonna use small x. See, this is what's gonna happen in x. It's gonna go far from you. And plus x is gonna get in near. And it's gonna rotate a little bit from by x axis, like by 1.0. It's gonna rotate. So next I'm gonna use small y. This is y. This is capital Y. This is small z. This is capital Z. So if we keep doing different values of this, see, at one point it'll become invisible. So we need to get him back, and here he is. So yeah, that's a cube, and yeah, this is basically a whole program. So thank you all of you for viewing this video, and it's really appreciated that you actually bear with me and my voice. So I hope you've understood the motive of our program, and if you haven't, please do search it on the internet. So sorry, thank you. Yes, and then. So that marks the end of our video. Thank you everyone for being so patient and listening to everything that I said. I hope you've understood the program now. And all the best, and thank you.